As of the end of 2021, electric cars are still nothing but a joke. Sure, you can now watch movies while you drive, but when it comes to actually getting to places, it will always end up with another adventure of a lifetime. We rolled into the only charging station in a 100-mile radius right when the battery died, and the car shut off. Aw, crap, it doesn't charge. It's either overheating or a bad cable. Might as well just give up and buy a diesel generator and a trailer. Low-distance range and long charging times are rather big issues, and that's only from the consumer's point of view. From a global perspective, mankind is ludicrously launching towards another ecological catastrophe. Lithium bad, you know, toxic production, fast degradation, hard to recycle. Even the most optimistic reports agree that the collecting, dismantling, and recycling of lithium batteries is barely sustainable, even on the current laughably small scale, versus what we are expecting the scale to grow to in an alarmingly short time. Meanwhile, an alternative electric vehicle battery exists and already works, and it works very well. It is the supercapacitor. Supercapacitors are something in between those small capacitors used in electronic devices and lithium batteries. It is a relatively old technology, so it does not require using child labor to mine rare metals in an unstable African country that's ready to fall apart and create another supply chain crisis. A variety of electrolytes can be used for producing supercapacitors, including absolutely non-toxic and environmentally friendly ones. In fact, there are a number of YouTube videos on how to make a supercapacitor at home. The chemical processes inside a supercapacitor are much less disruptive, so the cycle counts can reach hundreds of thousands or even a million, giving them a lifetime of a few decades. Supercapacitors can be charged very quickly, and they're absolutely safe. They don't need protection circuitry and just naturally stop charging when they reach the limit. Unfortunately, there is one enormous disadvantage. A supercapacitor can only carry 3-5% of the energy a lithium battery of a similar weight and size can store. Imagine a car that can only run for 20 kilometers. No one would care that it charges in 80 seconds. Supercapacitors can be and are used in hybrid vehicles. They also take over peak acceleration loads when connected in parallel with lithium batteries, and that prolongs the battery's life. But alone, they are not even close to being good enough for electric cars. Electric cars will have to continue using unethical, dangerous, and environmentally unfriendly lithium batteries. These traits just seem to be in that vehicle's nature. However, the same way that supercapacitors are unfit for private cars, they are a perfect match for public buses. There are a number of ways a supercapacitor-powered bus that has a range of 5-7 kilometers can work all day long in a giant sprawling megalopolis. It can recharge itself every few stops, preferably major ones, where many passengers take a sufficiently long time to get on and off the bus. China has been the world leader in deploying this type of bus since 2010, and they also sell them to Europe, from Bulgaria and Serbia to Austria. The Swedish Swish ABB Corporation also produces similar types of buses. Post-Soviet cities use supercapacitor-powered trolleybuses to extend existing trolleybus routes. They charge through the trolley wire in the city center, and then the trolley poles are pulled down, and the machine continues on its way to the newly built periphery districts without any investments to the infrastructure. Trolleybuses are bigger, so they can carry more supercapacitors, and this Belarus-produced trolleybus can run 20 kilometers on a single charge for a few minutes, and then run back. An inverse system is implemented in the Spanish city of Sevilla, where trams use supercapacitors to power themselves in the old town, where overhead wires might ruin beautiful historic views, and the actual reason, prevent Christmas decorations from being put up. They raise their pantograph once they reach more contemporary built-up areas, where catenary brings at least some variety to the dull surrounding landscape. Running across a predetermined route and being able to charge on the move are the two important traits that allow buses to overcome the number one problem that electric cars have by using supercapacitors and becoming the perfect electric vehicle that already exists today. Of course, it still would be better to avoid using any energy storage at all. This is an electric bus in Moscow. Silent and ecological, it says on its body. Why does it consume a full barrel of diesel fuel every day then? Because it's Moscow, it's cold, and in the winter, the bus interior must be heated for the sake of the passenger's health. The lithium battery must be heated as well, because it loses its capacity at below zero temperatures, like an ancient year-old smartphone, which, even being fully charged, suddenly turns off with the first snow. Battery-powered wireless technologies are less reliable by their nature. We still haven't managed to set up a wireless internet connection that does not slow down and drop out once in a while. We lost both our AirPods, and really cool kids are already back to wearing wired headphones again. We desperately put a battery into a drinking water pump, only to let it forever stay in one place with a charger permanently connected. What will we do with all these worn-down lithium batteries in the green, zero-emissions year of 2030? Current policymakers will already be retired by then. They won't even have to say they are sorry and that this situation could not have been foreseen. Meanwhile, the perfect electric vehicle has been here for 100 years. It's called the trolleybus. It charges in 0 seconds, and with that one charge, it can go for an infinite amount of kilometers. We should pay more attention to that inconspicuous Soviet guy who towed a trolleybus to his village, laid an internet cable for his desk, and has never given up his old headphones that he bought when he was in high school. He might just know something we don't.